Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This will be the final video of the series on video games. In this conclusive video, we will look at what video game developer got it right. How From Software got it right. Their DLCs. Bloodborne has a DLC called The Old Hunters and it is almost an entirely new game. It also plays different than the standard game. You cannot use the same weapons and tactics as the old game and this makes the difficulty ramp up. Which brings me to the next reason. Game mechanics. Like I said, Bloodborne and its DLC is completely different because the DLC is so difficult. I have never beaten the Orphan of Kos. Similarly, when comparing Bloodborne and Dark Souls, we see that Dark Souls is a game which favors hit and run tactics and awards players with patience. Whereas Bloodborne favors an aggressive play style, Sekiro favors stealth and you can jump and wall run, in a From Software game. And that's the point. It is these differences that force you to adapt your playstyle that make the games feel completely different and new. Advancing is as important as adapting, which brings me to the next point on the list. It doesn't bother me that much, but I know there are people out there that have this one at the top of their list, so I decided to include it. Graphics. When putting these games in chronological order, the graphical improvements are insane. Comparing Dark Souls 1 and 3, for example, shows a massive leap in detail. The only reason Bloodborne's graphics suck is because it's a console exclusive. I guess here we see that not even From Software is perfect. There is always room for improvement. Which brings me to my next point, about something they have improved upon dramatically. Interesting story plot. Dark Souls might as well have been written by Stephen King and if it was I wouldn't be surprised. The plot is vague, if there even is one. Bloodborne has a plot that can be pieced together a lot faster and I like the balance they found with this game. I could understand who I am, where I am, why I am there and what is happening, and later I could fill in all the holes in my knowledge with quick lore searches. Sekiro has a pretty easy to understand story, straightforward and simple. I have heard many people prefer this game above the rest because of this very reason. I also like the changes in time, reality, and culture. Whereas Bloodborne is focused on a plague in Victorian England, Sekiro is focused on Japan and its culture. But merely doing these things is worthless if not done thoroughly. Which brings me to the final point in the video, and thus sadly an end to this series. Quality assurance. These games are released after great care has been put into the final product. There are still exploits and minor bugs, but there are no game-breaking bugs. I have recently played Sekiro, which is a new game, and didn't experience any crashes or screen freezing. LOL Skyrim 10 years later. It's funny how I vowed as a kid to never waste my money on a From Software game because the games are unbeatable, and as an adult it's the only games I've been playing recently. Every game offers something different to go back to. The only flaw with any of these games or the developer is that Bloodborne is a console exclusive. What a waste of potential. Anyway, I guess I should end it here. Thank you all for tuning in and spending some time here with me. I appreciate it. Leave a like if you liked the series, leave a dislike if you hated it, and comment if you feel I missed anything. Until next time guys, Godspeed.